everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example of how to find the scalar equations of a line. The information that we're given for this problem are two points, P sub 1, which is equal to 3, 5, 7, and P sub 2, which is equal to 6, 5, 4. So along with this information, we're going to need a couple of formulas in order to find the scalar equations. X equals x sub 0 plus a times t, y equals y sub 0 plus b times t, and z equals z sub 0 plus c times t. We're also going to, before we can use these formulas, need to find a vector that relates to this problem. We can't use these formulas with just two points. We need to first use these two points to find the vector. Then we can use p sub 1 and the vector to along with the formulas to find the scalar equations. You always need a point and a vector, and we don't have the vector yet, so we have to use the two points to find it first. So the way that we do that is we subtract the points in or the coordinates of p sub 1 from the coordinates of p sub 2 loosely, and what I mean is we've been given coordinates here in the form x, y, z. Well, those correspond to I, j, and k, respectively, which are kind of the variables that we use with vectors. So we take the coordinate here in p sub 2, and we use the x coordinate as our coefficient on I here, the y coordinate as our coefficient on j, and the z coordinate as our coefficient on k. And we subtract from that the coordinate p sub 1. So we end up with 3i plus 5j plus 7k, which we get here from the point 3, 5, 7. So that's the way that we set up our vector equation, and that's the vector that goes from the point p sub 1 to p sub 2. And when we simplify that, we subtract 3i from 6i, so we're left with 3i. We subtract 5j from 5j, so we end up with 0j, and you can see that disappears here in our vector. And we subtract 7k from 4k, so we end up here with a negative 3k. So this is our vector, and now we're going to use this vector along with the point p sub 1 to plug into these formulas and find our scalar equations. So we're going to plug in 3, 5, and 7 for x sub 0, y sub 0, and z sub 0 respectively, because remember this coordinate is in the form x, y, z. So that plugs in for those three here. Then we're going to use our coefficients on I, j, and k for a, b, and c here respectively. So what that looks like, again, we'll plug in 3 for x sub 0, so you can see we've plugged in 3 here. Our coefficient on I is 3, so remember the coefficient on I goes in for A, so we end up with a plus 3t. And we always leave the variable t because our scalar equations are going to be in terms of t even in our final answer, so we leave that t variable in there. For Y, we'll plug in 5 for Y sub 0, and for B, we would plug in the coefficient on J. In this case, our vector indicates that j has completely dropped off, so the coefficient on j is a 0. So for y, we'll end up with 5 plus 0 times t, because this 0 gets plugged in here for b. We don't have j in our vector equation. Then for z, as you can imagine, we plug in our point 7 for z sub 0, and we plug in negative 3 for c, because negative 3 is the coefficient on k. So we end up with 7 minus 3t. Now, once you've gotten these three equations written down, you might be done if you've simplified as far as you can. In this case, we can simplify our y equation by dropping off that second term. So we're just left with y equals 5. So now when we put these three together, we'll get our final answer. So x equals 3 plus 3t, y equals 5 here, and z equals 7 minus 3t, and these three equations together constitute our scalar equations of the line. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!